Alright guys, welcome back to another episode, Why Not Me, and we are officially now 5.5 weeks out. Some big changes by the coach this week, a little bit of a drop in food, and a bit of an increase in intensity when it comes to cardio. I've got Josh with me again here. We're going to go over a back workout. That back is something that a lot of people really are struggling to grow and they struggle to connect with. So we're going to go over how to kind of target different parts of your back and how to grow a big back. But yeah, 5.5 weeks out, feeling a little bit more tired, but we're getting there, getting leaner. So yeah, let's get it done. All right, cool. So before we obviously get into the main bit of the workout, I'm just doing a few dynamic stretches. And just warming up my core a bit, just getting everything nice and tight, nimble and whatnot. I'm at this stage in prep now where I'm getting leaner and my joints are feeling a lot more vulnerable. So it's super important now that I'm stretching and getting things ready, because today is going to still involve heavy lifting. That doesn't change. I just need to make sure my body is ready for it and in a position to actually do it. So yeah, just doing a few stretches. I'm focusing on my hip flexors, my core, like my abs, my glutes, and yeah, just really mostly my hips, because yeah, my lower back is feeling a little bit glassy right now, so yeah, we need to get it ready. But yeah,
come here primitive, I die like a slave, riding on the wings of that Jesus name.
Callum's got me doing this workout where we're actually targeting the whole posterior chain. So I'm starting off with glutes. We're basically working our way from the glute all the way to the top of the back. So we'll start off with the glute, lower back with that kind of hip hinge in the deadlift that I'm going to do next. And then we're going to go on to the lats, so that insert kind of near the base of the spine. Then I've got kind of the upper back with a chest supported T-bar row. Then we're going to move on to another row, chest supported. Then we're going to finish with rear delts and some calves. So we're basically just focusing on the whole posterior chain. So that's why we're doing this. And this exercise gets fucking ruined by so many people. This is a glute bridge. So you'll see what I'm doing. As I'm kind of going down, I'm only using my hips to come down. There's not too much flexion in my knee to involve the quads. And I'm slowly driving up just to make sure that I'm extending at the hip. Yeah, great exercise. Let me just see what the master's orders are today on the menu. 265. 265. Okay, cool. Yeah, man, it's his first two exercises, man. Nerves. More so than what it would be for chest and biceps, delts and triceps. Anxiety, man, for you then. But I love it. It's great. See that form though? Oh, clean.
Your right hand never lost ground on no cold-blooded man. Yeah.
Thank God for stretching. We're gonna go 4 plates. And then top set will be around 200 kilos today. The last time I tried 200 kilos, my back gave way a little bit, so I'm a bit apprehensive, but we're moving on to a block pull, basically. Exercise 2, so we've hit the glutes. Now we're focusing more on lower back, bit of the hamstring as well in the movement, because it's a hip hinge. I'm pulling from blocks just because mechanically, it's just a more favorable position for me. Me pulling from the floor with such long, long legs, it just fucks me to the point that's not really necessary for what the goal is. The goal here is muscle, so I don't feel like I need to be pulling from the floor if it's gonna just fuck up my back for a couple of weeks. So yeah, pulling from the blocks is just, it's better for me. You don't have to do it with a big back, but what I do recommend is doing a hip hinge, like an RDL, a deadlift, a good morning, whatever the case may be. But yeah. Last week I literally pulled that for a double and it felt like my back was gonna fucking blow out. This one felt a bit better, but my belt's out was a little bit off, so I didn't really manage to brace correctly, but we'll take it, it's okay. We're gonna do one more set, we're gonna do a back of set with 170, and we'll move on to the next. The second set felt better. Josh actually gave me a little tip to do with my belt, and I just changed the position of the belt just to help me with the brace, and it felt much better. So that's the PR on that. So that's 170 for 10. I'll take that. And again, when I'm 5.5 weeks out and I'm doing that, it's ideal. It's really ideal. So next time I hit 200 on the next rotation when I do back, we'll basically just change the position of the belt, and we'll go for a PR on that as well. But, yeah, on to the next single arm lat pull down. So we've done glutes, hamstrings, lower back, the kind of meat and potatoes of the workout. So now we're gonna move on to a single arm lat pull down. We're targeting the lats. Single arm just allows you to target the lat a little bit more. You obviously have the conventional, normal lat pull down that everyone's familiar with, but what most people don't realize is that it actually targets your upper back a lot more than the lat. This movement allows you to actually get the lat really short because of the position that you're finishing in. So you'll see once I do a few warm-up sets, you'll see what I mean.
Oh.
you'll see that I'm driving the elbow downwards, and also my elbow never goes behind my spine. So it literally drives downwards, almost towards my hip. With a conventional lat pull down, your elbow is finishing up here. Like, you're not getting that portion of your lat short if you're just finishing here. So. At the top, I'm basically holding for a stretch for 2 seconds, and what that basically does is just ensures I'm on the right muscle. So I'm on the lat, I feel it, and I drive down with it. If I just kind of swing, all sorts of shit's involved. So just that little pause at the top, just make sure everything's on the lat. Alright, so lower back, lats almost done, but we're now going to move on to upper back. So we're going to do a chest supported movement. Chest supported just to take away any kind of involvement of the lower back. That's already been worked in the deadlift, we don't need to work it again. This focus now is literally just traps, rear delts, rhomboids, middle back area. So we are using these handles here rather than these ones here. Because you want the elbows to flare out. These people that complain that they have no calves, my calves won't grow, I've got high insertions, my genetics, my granddad had really bad calves. Bro, do you actually train your calves the same way you train your chest? Do you train them the same way you train your biceps? Answer that question honestly and then get back to me. It's still a muscle, you need to train it exactly the same way. And again, we're training this today because I need a bit more volume on my calves. And again, it's part of the whole posterior chain, it's part of the whole back. So when I turn around on stage, they're not gonna just be looking from like the top of my neck to like my hamstrings. This is involved as well, so. Bodybuilder, not upper bodybuilder, as Chris Jones would say. This is very, very ambitious. This is like a, actually it's not too bad. It's like a 5 kilo jump. We're gonna actually just finish off the lat here. I'm actually gonna do this row standing. It just puts me in a better position to get that lat short. If I'm sitting down, my elbow ends up right here and flared, whereas if I stand, I can kind of drive the elbow downwards. So that's gonna hit the lat. Last one for lats, and then the final exercise, we're gonna go on to rear delts.
PR or no?
Yeah, bro. That's still a PR. So I'm still getting stronger. The only thing, and I actually spoke to Callum this morning, the only thing that's still like compromising me at the minute is just twinges in the lower back and the hips. But that's things that I just need to address with like massage therapy and whatnot, and just making sure I'm on top of my mobility and my stretching. But everything else where I'm kind of stabilized by a machine, or yeah, pretty much just stabilized by a machine, I'm getting stronger every week still. And I'm on pretty much close to 2,000 calories at this point, so I do still believe that I am potentially building muscle at this point. I'm getting stronger. It doesn't mean because I'm dieting or in prep that there's no chance of me building muscle. I just need to address mobility issues. That's pretty much it. That's a wrap. Rear delts complete, back complete. Let's go eat. I mentioned on my story the other day, I wonder how many Cocoa Pops I've eaten, yeah, in total. I worked out, I think over the last like year, it's between like 400 and 500 kilos.
What?
Yeah. It's like, if I'm going by like, I was eating like around 200 grams after training. And I was training like 4 or 5 times a week. Yeah, that's like 800 grams, a kilo a week. Hold on.
Yeah, not 400.
Man said 400, believe that. Man said 400 kilos of cocoa. Cut that, bro, cut that. You can't be exposing my maths like that. 50 kilos. I was thinking like, hold on, there's not 400 weeks in a year.
All right, guys, that is back wrapped up. We pretty much covered the whole posterior chain. We started off with glutes, we moved on to the lower back, hamstrings, and then we moved on to the lats, upper back. Done a bit of calf work in there as well, and then finished off with rear delts. So hopefully you kind of took some pointers from working each muscle group in the back, and kind of just the next time you go and train, just have a little bit more thinking towards your training rather than just going in and just pulling weight. Having a bit more meticulous thought towards it. Obviously, it's still important to go and get strong and pull heavy stuff, but at the same time, you also want to have some thought about how you're training, what muscle you're training, and how that muscle actually moves the joint. I'm ready to pretty much go and eat now. One thing that has changed, I did mention earlier that Cocoa Pops, pretty much how much I'd eaten, they've actually now been removed from my plan. So I'm now just having cream of rice post-workout. The reason being is just because it's a little bit more filling than having like a bowl of Cocoa Pops, and it kind of just carries me over for a few more hours after I've trained. So yeah, just cream of rice now post-workout along with a banana and a shake, and then I'll have one more meal after that. I still need to do my cardio. That's one thing that's changed as well. So I'm now doing the Stairmaster 30 minutes rather than the incline treadmill. One thing that I've noticed that was a lot different in my off season is obviously when I was heavier, it wouldn't take a lot for me to get my heart rate going, do you know what I mean? So I could go for like a walk around the lake or whatnot and it would get my heart rate up, whereas now I'm noticing that I'm having to almost run to get my heart rate where it needs to be. And at this point in prep, when my joints are quite vulnerable, and it's important that we save all the energy for this training, if I'm running in my cardio, that's so counterproductive as to what the goal is here. I'm not a runner, I'm trying to hold as much muscle as possible. So we've got rid of that, we've got the Stairmaster in, 30 minutes, just down from 35 minutes, just because we want to manage fatigue a little bit through the legs. So yeah, 30 minutes, we've got to do that this evening. I'll eat my meal first and then go and get it done, along with some posing as well. And that's pretty much it. There was a bit of a food drop, but nothing too drastic. And then we're kind of just seeing how our body weight moves towards the end of this week. I woke up this morning at 99.2 kilos, which is actually the lowest I've been. It's pretty much a new low. And Callum reckons we can get to 98 by the end of this week, which would be really good to see. Everything is pretty much there. It's mostly just now coming off of the glutes and the hamstrings. But like I said, with this now cardio and the Stairmaster, well, we're going to burn more calories anyway. And a little bit less food, we're thinking it will take us there. But we'll see. And then the exciting stuff begins, where we begin to introduce high days, refeeds and whatnot, and see how my physique looks with a lot more carbs in it. Yeah, other than that, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. Make sure to subscribe. Next episode is going to be a good one, and take care.